Hello everybody and welcome back to round zero. Man, it's been a while. I hope everyone is having a great and fantastic day. Hope everybody's doing well and enjoying their lives. And I just want to talk about like how everybody else is talking about the Mike Tyson versus Roy Jones Jr. That is now, I believe, pushed back to November. It was initially stated in September, but I do believe now it is pushed to November. And since it has been a while from these two boxers into like the boxing ring, we are going to talk about their records. All right, so let's go into it. Let's start off with Mike Tyson. He is the former WBA, WBC, and IBF champion, heavyweight champion of the world. He has a record of 50 wins with 44 KOs, 6 losses with 2 non-contests. He has a reach of 71 inches. Now let's just get into his type of boxing style that Mike had, and it was just explosive. It was an explosive, in-fighting, aggressive fighter. You can feel his energy when he was up in that ring. Many boxers said before, when they went into that ring, they can just sense him. Sense, like, fear, the hype, like, just the readiness that I am going to destroy you and I'm going to knock the heck out of you type of feeling. You know, that's the kind of presence that Mike brought into the ring. Animal instinct, man. And he is my favorite type of boxing style, like his type of in fighting aggressiveness. Like he'll come in and just chase his opponent, come in with nice powerful right and left hooks, and like just dominating with uppercuts and switch it up. He'll duck and slip. He'll get really low too. He'll get really low to the point in which like his opponents can't really touch him, like the type of balance that Mike Tyson had in his prime was just amazing. And a lot of his fights were like just over before the third round. There's a lot of fights that he had was just one round KOs. Now I got the page up right here about Mike Tyson. I'm just counting. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I mean, a lot. It's just crazy how many fights he did with three rounds and less. Now let's talk about Roy Jones Jr. He has a total of 66 wins, 9 losses with 47 KOs, with a reach of 74 inches. He knows how to really set up his punches style. He can come in with a jab, he leaves with his jab, and it comes up with a nice straight. He's really good coming in and out for his opponent. Really good mid-range boxer. He knows how to come up and just sneak in hooks, sneak in nice jabs, and come in with a nice right to dominate his opponent and knocking them out. And his punches just flow. Like if he doesn't care, he's just very loose. He can do any kind of uppercut or angle punch to his opponent. He's really observant to what his opponent is throwing. He's really careful. He has locked eyes on his opponent, and he can just move around and tear his opponent apart. That's what I like about Roy Jones Jr. Now, Mike Tyson really needs to look after getting into the rhythm of Roy Jones Jr. Okay, he really needs to just keep making sure he keeps that close combat, chase after him, corner him, bob and weave, and make sure that he is unpredictable and comes up with those nice short hooks and uppercuts that Mike is really good at, and making sure that he never gets that distance into his range. Now, be careful with his traps, with his 1-2s, flip them, duck under him,
go as low as possible and aim for the body, okay? And he needs to be really good on his attack formation and just keep attacking Roy Jones Jr. Now, on the side of Roy, he really needs to set up basically just the opposite. He needs to keep setting up with his jab, maintaining his rhythm and his distance, jabbing him so he doesn't get close enough, he doesn't get into that mic, you know, like that mic explosiveness, push him down with a bunch of jabs, and just keep ripping him through one-twos, setting up one-twos, destroying his rhythm, messing it up, and keeping his range and his distance. He has the reach advantage. He would have to use that all the way towards the end of the fight. Keep coming up and probably coming in a couple of feints in there so he can, you know, get Mike into like a weird state, and then he can come up with a nice like uppercut or a nice right hook so that he can see if he's able to knock him down or not. He really needs to not get into that elusiveness. I guess he should really be paying attention towards his defense. He really needs to make sure that he doesn't get cut off with like a wild swing or a big like right hand or left uppercut from Mike, because he will go down. So just make sure that he's on top with his defense, watching out for Mike's coming in and towards him, using his jab and making sure that he's keeping his distance and throwing in a couple feints and using, really just demonstrating his domination of one-twos. So who do I have winning? Well, recent pictures have shown me what I've seen from both fighters at their age. Mike Tyson does look a better fit. He does look more in shape, and I actually do personally would like Mike Tyson to win, just because when he retired, the last fight that he did, he lost. You know, and that would be kind of cool that when he comes back, he can come back and like win and like get a nice team win. You know, nothing against Roy Jones Jr. I like him a lot as well. I think the slight favorite will go to Mike Tyson. I think he's just more fit as of now. It's up to November. I'm not sure what kind of training Roy Jones is doing. I've been looking into Mike Tyson's than Roy. But from the last pictures I've seen, Mike looks better fitted. And we'll just have to see when it comes down into November. You know, I'm really excited. I really do hope this happens and it keeps going. Like, I was kind of worried when they said it was not September, but they pushed to November. And if it needs to be pushed back again, that's fine. As long as it happens. If it can't be in November, hopefully it can, you know, as long as it happens, I don't care if they push it back until next year, you know. But for right now, it's happening in November, guys. What are you guys' thoughts? What do you guys think about this? Who you think is going to win? Let me know your predictions, if there's going to be a knockout. I don't know if there can be a knockout. I don't remember. I heard something about maybe they can. There's certain rules and restrictions about it. I'm not going to go into detail right now, but let me know what you guys think. Who's going to win? Is it going to be Mike Tyson or Roy Jones Jr.? Let me know down in the comment section below. Please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. I would really appreciate it. You know, until next round, guys, later.